Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another trigonometric substitution problem today. This one is the integral of 1 over x squared plus 1 squared dx. So the first thing we need to do is identify which of our three basic trigonometric substitutions we're going to make. In this case, because we have addition here, we've got x squared and 1, we have addition between the two, so we know we're going to be using the u squared plus a squared substitution, which is x equals a tangent of theta. So we're going to correlate this to u squared plus a squared, which comes along with the substitution u equals a tangent theta. So in order to solve for u and a, we'll set u squared equal to x squared, and we will set a squared equal to 1. We'll take the square root of both sides here with u squared equal x squared, and we'll get u equals x. Again, take the square root here of both sides and get a equals 1. So now we've solved for u and a, and we'll go ahead and plug those into u equals a tangent theta, and we will get x equals 1 times tangent of theta. So we've done that. The couple last things we need to do before we start substituting back into our problem is find the derivative of x, dx, and the derivative of x is going to be secant squared theta d theta, because the derivative of tangent of theta is secant squared of theta, and that's a formula that you should memorize. So we have d of x, and then the last thing we need to do is solve for tangent of theta, which is really simple to do. We'll get tangent of theta, we divide both sides by 1, and we get tangent of theta equals x over 1. I'm going to leave it in this form because it's helpful later on. But anyway, we can also simplify that over here and say tangent of theta equals x, because we'll probably want both. So we've done everything we need to do to set up for our problem. So now we go ahead and substitute back into our original integral for x and for d of x. So we will end up with the integral of 1 over, and we said that x was tangent of theta, so we will get tangent squared theta, because we have an x squared here, plus 1, and then that is squared, and then substituting in for dx, we'll put in secant squared of theta d theta. Secant squared of theta d theta. So now we've substituted, and all we need to do is simplify. So first thing we need to do, this tangent squared of theta plus 1, coming along with this substitution, or this identity here that was in our problem, and this substitution, it tells us to use the identity tangent squared of theta plus 1 equals secant squared of theta, which is a formula. So since we have tangent squared theta plus 1 in our problem, we can change that to 1 over secant squared of theta, which we plug in for this tangent squared of theta plus 1, and then we leave the squared because that's there. I'm going to go ahead now and erase this so it doesn't get in our way. So we have that, and then we'll leave the secant squared of theta d theta. So what we'll end up with is the integral of secant squared of theta over, since we have secant squared, and then that is also squared, we end up with secant to the fourth theta, and then d theta here at the end. And of course we can cancel out a secant squared theta from the numerator and denominator, so we'll end up with the integral of 1 over secant squared theta d theta. So secant squared, or I should say 1 over secant squared, is the same thing as cosine squared. So that will simplify to the integral of cosine squared of theta d theta.
which is about as simple as we can get our integral before we go ahead and integrate. What we'll have to do is use a formula for the integral of cosine squared of a variable. The formula for that integral is going to be, when we integrate that, 1/2 theta plus 1/4 sine of 2 theta plus c. So this is the integration formula when you have cosine squared of the variable. Now what we'll need to do, I'm going to go ahead and use the double angle formula for sine of 2 theta. Sine of 2 theta is the same thing as 2 times sine theta times cosine theta. That is a double angle formula because this sine of 2 theta means twice the angle theta. So 2 sine theta, cosine theta, and then of course plus c. So now we can simplify this if we get, if we multiply out 2 times 1/4 here, we'll get 1/2, and then this parenthesis can go away. So now I'm just going to go ahead and factor out the 1/2, 1/2 times theta plus sine theta cosine theta plus c. So now that we've simplified to this point, what we need to do is go ahead and convert this from thetas back to x's. And the way that we do that, we have to solve for theta. So we go back over to this formula here. We don't need the 1, but we need to solve this for theta. And the way that we do that is by raising both sides to the base tangent to the negative 1. So if we do tangent to the negative 1 of x equals tangent to the negative 1 of tangent of theta, that tangent to the negative 1 and tangent will cancel and we'll just be left with theta. So we've solved for theta, so we can plug in tan to the negative 1 of x for this theta here. So we'll end up with 1/2 times tangent to the negative 1 of x. And then for sine and cosine, we'll need to use our reference triangle for this substitution here. And our reference triangle we can draw down here. So we know that tangent is opposite over adjacent from trigonometry. So if we draw our reference triangle, and they always draw the reference triangle the same way, theta is here. Tangent, we've already determined, is opposite over adjacent, and we have x over 1. So that means x is opposite and 1 is adjacent. And then the hypotenuse is the square root of u squared plus a squared, which means it's the square root of x squared plus 1. X squared plus 1. So this is our reference triangle, and now that we have this, we can use it to plug in for sine and cosine. Because we know that sine is opposite over hypotenuse, so opposite x over hypotenuse, the square root of x squared plus 1 times cosine theta, and cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, so 1 over the square root of x squared plus 1 is for cosine, and then plus c. So now all we need to do is simplify, and it looks like our final answer will be 1/2 times tangent to the negative 1 of x plus, and we can combine these, we'll have x on the top, and since we have a square root times a square roots will go away, and we'll just be left with x squared plus 1 on the bottom, and then plus c. And that is our final answer. So thanks guys, I'll see you next time. Bye!